In this video, we're going to be talking about f-strings and some of the cool things that you can do with them. So most of you are probably already aware of what f-strings are. It's this kind of notation where you can put in f, little f or capital F, it actually doesn't matter, and then you have some literal stuff, and then within the string, you can put more Python code. So this is really useful, and it was introduced in, I think, Python 3.6. But what you may not know is that there's a lot of extra stuff that you can put in between these curly braces to modify what actually gets printed here. So in this first example, we're just printing something out, and you would just see the value is other dog face. But one of the really cool things that you can do is just put an equal sign afterwards, and then that will actually print out basically what's before the equal sign, then the equal sign, and then the value of what's before the equal sign. So if we go ahead and run this code, let me go ahead and make this bigger for you. You can see the first one, we just have the value is other dog face. And then in the second one, we see string value equals, and then the wrapper of that variable. So this is extremely useful, especially for debugging purposes. If there's some variable in your code, like num value, and I just want to add a quick debug print statement, I can just say, oh, let me add in num value equals kind of print statement in here. And then immediately you can see it comes out as num value equals something. And that's really useful. I wouldn't really use it in production code, but especially for debugging purposes, I end up using it a lot more than I probably should. Another cool thing about this is that you can actually add spaces basically anywhere in there, and it will preserve the spaces. So if you really like having, everything nicely printed out, then you can do that, put a space before and after in here, and you see it down here when it's printed out. And this last example, you can see that you can actually have arbitrary expressions there. And so it will print out, you see num value %2, num value %2, that part just gets printed out, and then the value of that expression gets substituted after the equal sign. So that's a really cool hidden trick of f-strings that you might not have known about. Even though f-strings have been in Python since Python 3.6, this equal sign ability has only been in since Python 3.8. So if you're not using a pretty recent version of Python, then you might not have access to this yet. But if you do, that's great. It's super useful. Okay, next example, conversions. So if you're not aware, inside the curly braces of an f-string after the expression, you can put a exclamation point A, exclamation point R, or exclamation point S. And what these do is, instead of printing the value of this thing, it will additionally do some extra thing on top of that. So R will call the wrapper. So this one right here, let's print it out. You can see that I get the quotes in the string printed out with it, and that's because the wrapper of a string actually has the quotes in it. So this second one here is actually equivalent to if I said print the wrapper out. The reason that you would want to use this bang R instead of writing wrapper out is because you're probably doing this for debugging purposes. Let's say that thing that you actually wanted to print out was, a nice formatted thing, string value, but something wasn't working quite right. So you say, let me just print out the wrapper so I can see exactly what's being printed, and that'll help clear things up. So what's this bang A here, this exclamation point A? That actually stands for ASCII. So if you are not familiar with what that does, it's similar to wrapper, it's very similar to wrapper, except that all of the basically non-ASCII characters get replaced by an ASCII safe escaped version of it. So this dog face that I have here, really cute, but if we're limited to just ASCII strings, I need to escape that with this backslash U001F kind of stuff. So in Python 3, I don't really see a big need for doing this kind of thing, but this is more similar to how Python 2 wrappers worked. But maybe you just don't want to print out dog faces because, I don't know why anyone wouldn't want to print out a dog face instead of this nasty thing, but I guess you can do that. And then, of course, your next question is probably, well, you said there was A, R, and S, so what's the purpose of S? Well, if you do that, it calls the string conversion operator on the type. And you might think, well, why would I ever want to do that when the default is to do that? You know, if I did nothing, what it's going to do is call the string conversion operator and print it out that way. It's not going to print out the wrapper. And the reason that this bang s exists is because this actually gets applied before another thing that you can do, which is formatting. And that'll be our next example. So if you're wondering about the bang s, it's for formatting. So if you do one of these things and then do something that I'm going to show you in the formatting operator, it will apply this either string conversion or wrapper conversion or ASCII conversion, and then apply the formatting after that. So it can be useful. I usually don't ever do that though. Okay, so let's get to the formatting example here. So I've got a whole bunch of little examples and we'll just, you know, see how they all work. So basically every type can define what it means to define its own formatting. So I have here, you know, a float value, and here I have a date time, and in my F string, I can put a colon and then format string. So the format strings are actually specific to the type. So the things that I can put here for a date time are different than the things that I put here for a numeric value. So you can see here, if I have a date time, I can print it out year, month, day, like that, and that'll work. So I'll go ahead and run it, and you can see now equals 2021-06-14. So that format string works for date times, and then for, you know, numeric values, this 0.2f is actually a format string telling me I want two decimal places. So you don't have to manually round things. You can just say I want two decimal places, and then the formatting library or the formatting function within the number class that you're using will handle the rounding and displaying part for you. So what's actually going on under the hood here is a little bit easier to see if you define your own class. So here I've defined this my class, and let's see what it does. It's just an empty class, and all it does is define a format method, which takes a format spec and is supposed to return a string. So let's see what happens when we use our own class in one of these format, you know, things, and see what actually happens when it gets called. So when I go ahead and run it, you can see that I see my class dunder format called with format spec equals blah, blah, blah. So you can see this blah, blah, my format stuff is exactly what was after the colon inside of the F string in the curly braces. So that is getting passed as an argument, the format spec argument, to the dunder format method of the class. And you can do whatever you want with that information. So it's totally up to you. In this case, I just, you know, totally ignored the information and just always return my class open close paren. This is a way to allow your own class to decide what are some special ways that I can be printed out. So that's not something that I do super often, but it's kind of more important that you just know that that's what the syntax is doing. Basically, whatever you pass here is just getting passed to a special function of the class. And so you can look up each class in the documentation is going to tell you what its format strings are and, you know, how to make use of them. So especially for numbers, this, you know, automatically rounding to two decimal places, I do that all the time. So just be aware that that's another thing. All right, well, that's all I've got on F strings and little F string tricks. I hope you enjoyed this little more informal video. And I just wanted to give a quick shout out to my patrons on Patreon. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate your support. See you next time.